How confident are you in spotting real information from not real information?
Okay.
I was put to the test.
Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
I had to try and spot real video and real audio from deepfakes.
Okay. Deepfake, maybe? Yay! It seemed really random. Like, why was there a video of her just, like, staring at her phone, like... real, I think?
That was a deepfake!
That actually looked like it was like part of the movie. I mean, it sounds real.
That was a deepfake, Drake.
That literally sounds just like him.
With the technology behind deepfakes improving at super speed, it's harder to spot real information from something that's made up. So let's go back to the basics and explain why seeing isn't always believing. This is Kayan Explains, Outsmarting Deepfakes. What do people mean when they say deepfake? A deepfake is not a Photoshop trick or a filter. It's most often an image, video, or audio clip that's been changed using artificial intelligence. The term deepfake has a dark history. It comes from a user on Reddit who went by the name Deepfakes. The user Deepfakes would make fake sexual videos of celebrities by swapping their faces onto bodies that weren't theirs. Even though the word fake is in the name, these deepfakes can often trick people into thinking something unreal is real. While some deepfakes can seem innocent enough, like this one, where the creator swaps the Spider-Man actor Tom Holland with the previous actor Tobey Maguire and is totally upfront about it. Deepfakes can quickly become some serious stuff. It can be a personal attack. You might know or heard of someone who's had a deepfake made of them. Teens in parts of the US and Canada are being victimized by deepfake nudes. It can be part of a crime or scam. Recently, a deepfake cost one company millions. 200 million Hong Kong dollars, that's about 34.7 million Canadian dollars, was transferred to a scammer after a businessman thought he was talking to his boss on a Zoom call. Turns out, that was a deepfake of someone impersonating his boss. Or they could affect wars, politics, and democracy. Like this manipulated video that appears to show Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky telling his troops to surrender to Russian forces. It went viral online, and many who saw it thought it was real. So if we can't always trust what we see and hear online, how do we spot deepfakes? And how do we know which information to trust? The experts we spoke to said the line between real and unreal is getting thinner. As artificial intelligence grows, deepfakes will become harder, if not impossible, to spot. Less than a year ago, I might have suggested looking at the hands of an image.
AI-generated content can look really real. Do you have any tips for spotting it?
If you look at this Pope picture, he's actually not really holding the coffee mug, and it's just kind of below his hand.
AI-generated images and deepfakes used to struggle depicting hands, like in this example. Or in some deepfakes, the lighting can look all wrong and things can blend together. But deepfakes are getting more and more realistic at a faster and faster pace, so those tips aren't as useful anymore. One hack to outsmarting deepfakes is something we all need to practice. It's known as critical thinking. Before believing something you see, hear, or read, we have to stop and ask ourselves a few questions. Now, you've probably heard this before. It comes down to the 5 W's and 1 H. Who? Who is presenting this information and what is the source? Is it a TikTok video from an account you can't trace or a trusted news organization? Is it an official government or celebrity page? What? What is being said or shown? Is the information shocking? Does it seem too good to be true? Where? Where is this information coming from? What is the source? Can I track down where it was first posted? When? When was this information recorded? Can I verify it? Why? Why is this information being shown? Could there be an ulterior motive? How? Before I share a belief, I have to ask myself the final question. How do I know this is real? We've learned that we have to go a lot deeper, beyond the surface, to understand and spot deepfakes. And we now know that seeing is no longer the key to believing. For CBC Kids News, I'm Isabelle MacNeil.